of Marathon Next Gen and a rare interaction talking about growth. Well, the company doesn't talk often, but of course on NDTV Profit they gave out certain figures and of course the outlook for the year ahead. Let's move on. HCL Infosystems, the stock rallied yesterday. The stock is still doing well. A whole host of changes have been done. Restructuring, I would say, at a broad level. A transfer of hardware business, learning business has been shifted. Service business has been transferred to another entity. The board has also approved the merger of HCL Infocom. We have the management joining us, Harsh Chaitale, who is the CEO at HCL Infosystems, joining us from Delhi. Harsh, great having you with us. Good morning. Let's understand the rationale for this restructuring, all the units that have been hived off into separate entities. Can you give us a sense? Are we looking at an eventual listing of all these separate arms?
So I'll give throw some light on it. Right now, we've initiated the process. The units have not yet been hived off because, as you know, it's a 7 to 8 month process of going through court approval, shareholder approval, and so on. So yesterday, we just announced the intention of doing so and informed stock exchanges accordingly. But as of now, the action is not yet completed. Having said that, when this action is completed, we would have a standalone hardware solutions business, a separate services business, and separate learning business. Primary driver for doing that, I would say, is two or three. Number one, they are different businesses needing different focuses and priorities. Three different businesses with three different mindsets needed. Hardware and solutions business, as the industry is going through a stress, commoditized hardware industry is not growing, and hence it's a business where right now consolidation and cost takeouts are underway, and that's a different mindset than what we need in our services and learning, where there is a huge headroom for growth. It's a large opportunity and high EBIT margins in that business. Hence, we wanted to ensure that there are different mindset and focus areas given to each of them. That was our driver number one. And second driver was that services business does need to be arm's length from our hardware business, because services could business could offer services not just for HCL hardware, but potentially also to competing hardware vendors, because that's a capability that is actually brand agnostic. And hence we wanted to create that arm's length separation between the two to unconstrain growth of our services capability. So that was the rationale. We expect this process to be completed through all the regulatory approvals over the next 6 to 8 months.
Once the approvals are in place, I'm assuming in all probability some of those subsidiaries would actually get listed separately. Can you talk about that? How soon are we looking at that?
As of now, there is no plan of doing so. However, the structure would enable us to take any such corporate actions or seek different strategic partnerships or strategic investors. However, primary driver was not that, and that is not something that's on the anvil as of now.
Any perhaps probability of some kind of partnership to perhaps look at a joint venture with some other foreign players or a local entity to actually significantly enhance the visibility of any of these businesses, whether it's learning, system integration, or even the services business?
So the structure would enable all such actions, and there would be a distribution player, let's say, who wants partnership only in distribution area, or a learning content player, a global content player who may want partnership only in learning and may want to do nothing with the hardware business. So all that would get enabled, and hence that's one of the considerations. But is there anything on the anvil? No.
Okay. All right, Harsh. Thank you so much for joining us, giving us an update on the restructuring. Of course, we'll be in touch with you. We'll keep bringing you back as that restructuring story unfolds. And I'm assuming once those companies, entities start to get listed separately. We'll move on. Let's talk about NHPC.